We thank you for Jesus Christ, your Son. He went to Calvary's cross and died, and laid the tomb, and he rose triumphantly from the grave. Up from the grave, he arose. The mighty 12 warriors falls. He arose a victor from the dark domain, and he lives forever with his saints to me. Hallelujah! Christ arose. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord, for this resurrection celebration. Easter day, O God, we thank you. We bless you. We adore you. We praise you for your great love manifested in Jesus Christ, our risen Savior, our King of Kings, Lord of Lords. Thank you, Father. We bless your name. We come, Lord, confessing our sins, for we have often strayed and we have not lived like children of the resurrection. Your light will not always shine forth from our lives. And so, Lord, we ask for your forgiveness. We ask your forgiveness when we have not risen to the challenge, when we have not heard your voice nor obeyed your voice. Father, forgive us, cleanse us, wash us, and renew us, O God, on this Easter Sunday. Cause resurrection power to arise, O God, in our lives and flow from our lives, O God, to a world that is in need of your touch. And Father, we thank you and we praise you that you are in our midst. And we thank you for the hope, for the joy, for the power that our risen Savior affords us, offers to us, and enables us by your God, so that we can live, Lord, in this world that is in need of your touch. We thank you, Father, for you have brought us through so many dark places and winding pathways. And you, Lord, are carrying us even now, God, in these days, Lord, that inspires fear and anxiety. We thank you for our risen Savior who gives us hope and joy, O God, because we are overcomers by the precious blood of Jesus Christ, the Lamb for sinners slain and the risen Lamb. Thank you, Father. We bless you and we praise you. We pray for believers everywhere, for those who are members of the household of faith, O God. Bless us as we gather together, O God. Even though we may be gathered publicly in diminished numbers, O God, our praises are rising up, for we will not have the stones competing with us, O God. So we thank you and we praise you. We pray for those who are most in need of your touch, those who are on the front lines, O God, especially in this time, in this pandemic time, O God, and era, O God. We thank you that you, Lord, are with us, and we ask to continue to be with us and with them in a special way. Those who are suffering across the spectrum of suffering that we have because of especially this pandemic, and all others who were suffering before. Father, we pray that this Easter Sunday will inspire us to come to you and to avail ourselves to you, that we may be a source of healing to this world. Father, we give you thanks. Continue to inspire us and enable us to praise you this Easter Sunday. We ask all these mercies and all God's people say,
amen.
Amen.
Amen. Let us continue to worship Almighty God as we lift our voices in the hymn number 116. Jesus Christ is risen today, hallelujah. Our triumphant Holy Day, who did once upon the cross, sin, the Redeemer of our Lord, hallelujah. Let us sing to the glory. Son of God. From him and through him and for him all things exist. And we through him. He became flesh and lived among us, taking the form of a servant, Jesus of Nazareth, the Son of Man. He was tested in every way as we are, yet without sin. He spoke of what he knew and testified of what he had seen. To all who put their trust in him, he gave the right to become children of God. Here is the Lamb of God who takes away the sin of the world. He suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. And on the third day he rose again. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again to judge the living and the dead.
This is my Lord who loved me and gave himself for me. Purchased and redeemed me.
Greater than space. is. And so we worship a true and living God. And so to one and all, I say a very special welcome.
Let us all sing to the glory of our
You will help us to hear. Help us to listen, O God, and help us to apply. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Amen.
Please be seated. The Lord is risen.
He is risen indeed. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Amen.
As we celebrate the first Easter this morning, many of us may be feeling a bit anxious and isolated due to the restrictions put in place to try and stop the spread of the coronavirus.
Yes.
The pandemic is indeed affecting us in so many ways. I believe some of us have never washed our hands so many times in one day. The doctor or doctors around us, those that didn't study, the self-appointed ones, you know the ones I'm talking about, will come to the conclusion and diagnose you with the coronavirus. Listening to the radio and remind us as we celebrate. God will never lie, never deceive, never mislead. God will not change his mind. Can I say to us this morning, trust God. Yes. We can rely on God to keep his promises in every situation that we are faced with. These promises are his trustworthy pledge to us. So as we reflect, as we celebrate, as we go through the changing scenes of this life, hold on to the fact that God's promises are true.
Amen.
Because of his promises, we can face tomorrow.
Yes.
Why? Because he is risen, and he is risen indeed.
Amen.
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 Let us continue in prayer as we turn to our liturgy for Easter on page 138 to 139. Let us pray for the church. O God of unchanging power and eternal life, look favorably on our whole church, and by our tranquil operation of your perpetual providence, carry out the work of humanity's salvation. And let the whole world feel and see that those things which had grown old have been made new, and that all things shall attain perfection through him from whom they took their origin, even through our Lord Jesus Christ. Amen.
Amen.
Let us pray for those in trouble. God, you are the source of all comfort and consolation. We pray today for those who are sick and suffering, for the widow and widower, for the motherless and fatherless, for the sad and despairing. Reveal yourself to each woman and teach them to find in you the strength in all trouble and the refuge in every time of anxiety.
Amen.
Let us pray for the aged and dying. O God, though all else should fail, we remain true, and through all things, though all things die, you live. We pray for those who are near the end of the earthly pilgrimage, that they may spend the remaining days in your presence and meeting death with the strength of your grace, may pass into nearer light to your knowledge and love.
Amen.
God of peace, whose Son, our Lord Jesus, was brought back from the dead to become the great shepherd of the sheep, by the blood that seals eternal covenant, equip us to do your will in everything that is good, that our lives may always be acceptable to you, to Jesus Christ, to whom be glory forever and ever. Amen.
Amen.
Let us continue to worship God as we sing the hymn number 126. God sent his Son, they call him Jesus. He came to love, heal, and forgive. He lived and died to buy my pardon, and empty grave is there, who my Savior is. Let us all sing to the glory of Almighty God.
Thank you. Let us pray. Gracious God, we join with those who are celebrating another milestone in their lives. Those who are celebrating birthday this week. Those who are celebrating wedding anniversary. Those who are celebrating anniversaries at the workplace. We thank you, O God, that by your grace and by your sustained power, you have brought them to this hour of celebrations. And so we join with them, Lord, in giving you thanks and praise for your divine provision, for your protection, for your strength, for the hope that you have implanted in our hearts. Today, as we celebrate Easter, Lord, we thank you for the power of the risen and exalted Christ. We thank you for the presence of the risen and exalted Christ. And we pray that those who celebrate may experience in you that presence and that power of Christ, that hereunto they may live their life victoriously. They may live their life in courage. They may live their life in hope, because Christ is with us, risen and exalted. These mercies be ours. In the name of the risen and exalted Christ, who is alive forevermore. Amen.
Brothers and sisters in Christ, this is Reverend Elaine C. Christopher, Superintendent of the Moravian Church Virgin Islands Conference. The Lord is risen. He is risen indeed. Up from the grave he arose with a mighty triumph for his foes. He arose a victor from the dark domain, and he lives forever with his saints to reign. He arose. He arose. Hallelujah. Christ arose. Christ is alive, my brothers and sisters, and because he lives, we can face tomorrow. As children of God, we have no need to fear. Our God has the whole world in his hands. I want to encourage us to trust God and to obey the protocols established for our safety. To all essential workers, thank you for I believe he's the only one we can safely get close to. Capitalize on this opportunity. Isaiah chapter 41 and verse 10 says, "Don't be afraid, for I am with you. Don't be discouraged, for I am your God. I will strengthen you. I will help you. I will uphold you with my victorious right hand." Brothers and sisters, be assured that Jehovah has the final say. A blessed Easter to each of you and to your families. Hallelujah! Christ is alive.
Thank you.
blessing us.